happy holidays to everyone out there. We're going to have a fantastic show today. It's going to be fun. I have with me Roland Bennett with People's Mortgage Company. Roland, you have been on my show for years. I love having you on, and you've helped so many people out there with getting mortgages, you know, loans for any kind
sure.
of thing.
Yeah, and I love being on your show, and happy holidays to everybody out there right now driving around. I know it's a, you know, hectic time on the streets. Just remember, tune your radio to 1100 AM, put two hands on the wheel, and just relax, okay, people?
You know, I absolutely know one thing about you, a couple things about you, I should say, that everybody should know. First of all, you're a hugely creative person, and you're great with numbers. Would you please walk with us, sort of like the how the pre-qualification works?
Well, absolutely. You know, I deal with a lot of people, you know, that come to me and they say, we're just not sure what we can do. We want to find out if we even qualify. And so it's more than just, you know, walking into a bank and getting the loan. The creative piece is that you kind of have to know how to meander through underwriting guidelines. And I love doing that. I have a lot of fun helping people be problem solvers with their finances as far as getting that loan approved. And, you know, in college I was a math major and I minored in creative writing. So it's sort of the perfect path for mortgage lending. And I love doing what I do, especially with the self-employed people. They feel, you know, I feel like people that are self-employed with complicated tax returns need more creativity, you know, in solving that problem and getting the loan. So I love numbers. I love working with numbers. Mortgages is all about, it's a numbers game, period. You know, people find out when they talk to me that loans are approved or not approved based on three main things. And getting a loan comes down to three main points: income, credit, and assets, period. You know, 12 years ago in the good old days, in the boom and bust, all you needed was credit, because assets and income had nothing to do with the loan, which is crazy. But income, the way they look at income is debt-to-income ratio on a monthly basis. So everything's broken down to monthly expenses. It's broken down to what your income comes down to monthly income. All your expenses are what your expenses are monthly. So that monthly car payment, the monthly credit card payments, what your monthly mortgage payment's going to be. All those things added up and then divided into what your monthly income is. And that's where the self-employed people really can use my help, is because what you make as a self-employed business owner isn't always what's on your tax returns on paper. You know, if I'm a teacher and I have a $50,000 salary, it's very easy to look at a pay stub and my last year's W-2 to show that I make $50,000 a year or $4,300 a month. But with self-employed borrowers with multiple businesses and, you know, a couple of rental properties, you know, flowing into a, you know, into their Schedule E, and the Schedule E is kind of weird because when you take an 1120S return for a business return and you pull your K-1 income out of that and it also goes on the Schedule E, you know, everything kind of gets jumbled up together. And a lot of people at the banks, you know, I'm talking Johnny Cubicle down at the, you know, the big box banks, they look at a tax return that has two or three businesses and a couple of K-1s and maybe a partnership with some rental properties. It's deer in headlight. And they say, you don't make enough money, because the AGI on the bottom of the tax returns, you know, adjusted gross income on page one of their personals, is a low number. And you look at that low number and say, oh, yeah, you're not going to qualify, man. You don't show enough income in your tax returns. But it's not always that line. So that's where I can help people understand where that income comes from.
Now, I understand that you're also licensed in like 16 states. And this is the holidays. The people are all got family in town. And
yes.
Where do they want to live but here in Arizona?
Well, of course, everybody's coming to Arizona. We have very few hurricanes. We have not had a mudslide in centuries.
We did have hail, though.
We had hail. We had a little bit of hail up
that
in Flagstaff.
That was our snow. I remember I took a picture of my trash can. It had a little bit of, like, I don't know, it looked like ice on it. And I was like, yay, snow.
And it's, you know, it's no surprise that it gets a little hot in the summertime. But the nice thing about the heat is that you can still golf, and the sun comes up earlier, so you can tee off at about 5:30 in the morning, which makes it great because you can get 18 holes in before the triple digits arrive.
When you work with people, you do free consultations?
Absolutely, I do free consultations, and you know, with being the holidays, if your family's smart, they're visiting you in the wintertime around the holidays, and you're visiting them in the summertime. You know, it took my family and I a few years, almost 5 to 10 years to figure that out. We were still going back to Chicago for Christmas, and they're coming out here in the summertime.
Yeah, really?
But, you know, I am licensed in many other states. So if you have family coming in town from California or from Oregon or Washington, Tennessee, Illinois, Minnesota, Wisconsin, Iowa, South Dakota, Michigan, I'm licensed in Florida, but a lot of times we're going to Florida, you know, around the holidays.
Really like
it. So, but I can help those people too.
You mentioned people who are self-employed, and I want to
Yes.
talk about that because it's huge what you can do for us self-employed people.
Well, self-employed people, what I've found is that they're very, very good at running their business, and then they take all the paperwork into their tax, you know, their CPA at the end of the year, and they say, here's all my stuff, and then the CPA does the best thing for them tax-wise, right? The old saying in the mortgage business is, you know, being self-employed is great when it comes time to pay taxes, not so great when it comes time to buy a house, because a lot of them have trouble showing income. So I work with self-employed people to help make sure that their accountants are taking their actual business deductions in the right places. And one prime example of that is auto deductions. Right, so I'm a pool guy or a realtor, and I'm driving around, you know, all the time and putting a lot of miles on my car. If I write off the expense that I spend on gasoline and car expense, those are deductions that are going to come off my total business income that I can't regain anywhere on my tax returns. However, if I'm self-employed and I write off the business miles instead of the business gas expense, I can now take 24 cents per mile as long as it's on page 2 of the Schedule C on line 44A, you know, as business miles traveled, I could take 24 cents per mile and add that back into income. I had a pool gal, my pool person, she put 40,000 miles in her car, and I helped her with a mortgage loan. Because she wrote those 40,000 business miles off in the right spot on the taxes, I was able to add $10,000, which is $800 a month in qualifying income that she would not have gotten had she written off that same expense as a gasoline expenditure.
I'll tell you, Roland, you are so awesome when it comes to this. You are passionate about what you do. You help so many people. I've known you for years. You've been coming on this show. You've helped a lot of people out here. A lot of people may even have more than one home that you can help them with. Of course, all those 16 states. The best thing to do for them to do is just call you, have a consultation.
Call me, send me a text message. You know, the last time I was on your show, Carol, way back in October, I can't believe it feels that long ago. I actually got a text message from a guy, and he was having trouble with a local bank that he was dealing with, and they couldn't get him pre-qualled. And actually, he should be, he's closing right after the first of the year. I got him qualified, he went out, he found a house, and he's really happy. So the best thing to do is text me on my cell phone number, 602-513-3686. You can find me on the web, RolandBennettLoans.com. All my contact information is on there as well. And after the break, Carol, I'm going to tell you why I'm so passionate about this and how I got into this business.
Well, if you're driving, please don't text right now. Pull over, like he likes to say. Pull over and be safe, and then you can text.
You got to take the plunge there.
The number to call is 602-513-3686. It's 602-513-3686. It's Roland Bennett with 2TLoans.com. Hang tight. We'll be back in just a minute. I'm here with Roland Bennett with People's Mortgage Company. And Roland, I got to ask you, I don't know if I've even asked you this throughout all the years that you've been on my show. How did you get into this business?
Well, and that's a funny question. You know, I got into this like a lot of people, I think, end up in careers. I had a bad experience when I moved to Arizona with buying a house. I moved to Arizona almost 17 years ago, and we were buying a house. I was not in the mortgage business yet, and we were purchasing a house, my wife and I, who was my girlfriend at the time, and we had no idea why they were asking us for what they were asking for. We didn't know what underwriting guideline they were trying to, you know, settle. We didn't know why they kept asking for certain things, had no clue what was going on, just, you know, kept providing stuff, and is everything okay? Does this work? I mean, when are we going to hear? And, you know, and so we're in this process, and I find that a lot of people there, they go out and buy the house, and, you know, buying a house and thinking about moving, and, oh, we're going to put Johnny Joe's bedroom there, and Sally Sue's going to be over there, and, oh, our kids are going to have such a good time in the, you know, background. They're thinking about that, but yet all of that excitement of this new house they're buying is sucked out of them by this big stressful loan process because they don't know if their loan's going to go through.
Right.
You know, and that happens a lot, even this day. I can't even believe it happens this day. And I thought, oh my goodness, I can't even believe this. I looked into the business. I thought, man, this I should be doing this. This is perfect for me because what I want to do is make sure that everybody that I work with does not go through what I went through. I don't like the mystery of whether or not my loan's going through. I don't like not knowing why they're asking me for a pay stub from a year and a half ago because there was something funny on it. And I thought, you know what? This needs to change. There's something in this industry needs to change. There needs to be more of a consultant person versus the big, you know, the shadow. Remember the game Deal or No Deal? And they would call the banker and it was the shadow of a person and they were waiting to see what the deal was. Too many people find themselves in that Deal or No Deal, you know, when waiting to see what the offer is, waiting to see if the loan's going to be approved. In the middle of a purchase contract.
Right, they should.
You can't do that.
Yeah.
So I thought, I got to get into this. I've got to make this process better for people. And I learned the business. I got into it. And that's what I really, really am passionate about, is the explanation and the education with the home buyer, not when they're in contract, but before they even write a contract. If you come and work with me, I'm going to tell you exactly what the banks are looking for, why they're looking for that, what the different loan programs are, what the payment's going to be, how much your down payment's going to be, what are the closing costs. Exactly. Here's the two things you want to know when you buy a house. How much do I got to fork up, you know? How much do I got to cough up right now to buy it? And what's that mortgage payment going to be every month for the next 30 years or however long I own the house? Those are two very important information.
Well, I'll tell you something. There's another thing that they should know, is what the difference is between coming to you and going to a major bank.
Well, I transparency. I want to say that. You come to me, right? I just had this situation on the phone today. I had somebody call me up and said, hey, my realtor told me to call you because we went in to get our pre-qualification at Wells Fargo and they took all of our information and we're trying to make an offer and they said that we should hear something by Monday or Tuesday. Monday or Tuesday? Are you kidding me? So in that phone call where the person called me, I got his information over the phone. I put it into the application. I ran his credit. I emailed his credit report. I told him what his score was. I told him if we could, you know, I told him how we could maybe approve it a little bit to get a little bit of a rate. I told him exactly what the underwriter's going to look for. He sent over the information. I gave him a pre-approval, not only a pre-qual. I ran his file on the phone on the very first phone call contact with this borrower. I ran a pre-approval through Fannie Mae's automated underwriting system that the underwriters are going to run. So when I have somebody that I ask for a piece of paper from, they know exactly why I'm asking for it. They know, they understand why the underwriter is looking at that. And they know that they have to come up with these things before they're out there making offers.
Right. The main thing that you guys want to do out there is you do want to go get pre-approved. It's all about that. Now, you can't even really work with somebody unless you
got it. You've got to know the money's going to be there and not be stressed about it. The last thing you need to do is sit there wondering if the loan's going to go through. Are you kidding me?
One thing that I do know that's happened in the real estate world, you know, especially with mortgages and everything, is that it's changed so much. It used to be so much easier, obviously, before the big crash and everything. But now it seems like, I mean, they want more than blood from you.
Well, a good illustration of that, and I'm not going to exaggerate. The average loan program's underwriting guidelines, if you look it up and pull the PDF online through Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac for a VA loan, FHA loan, USDA, conventional, whatever, the average guidelines, if you scroll down to the very bottom page on the PDF on your computer, you're at page about 950. That's how many pages of underwriting guidelines there are. And underwriting guidelines are just reasons why the bank won't give you the loan, right? When I submit a loan to the underwriter, you've got the appraisal and your pay stubs and the driver's license and the purchase contract and the title report, the whole thing, right? My average loan submission from my processor to the underwriter is 500 pages. So I'm submitting 500 pages of stuff that they're underwriting on 900 pages of what they're looking for. I mean, so it sounds complicated, but at the same time, my job is to be the barrier between that chaos and make it easy for people to understand.
It's RolandBennettLoans.com. You can either call them or text them, 602-513-3686. I got to say this, you know what? It's the holidays, right?
It is, you know, it is the holidays.
A lot of people out there are out there right now. It's just the place where people want to live. I understand that Scottsdale is the number one place where people want to move.
Well, I'll tell you what, I was just down at the local Safeway, ringing the bell, Salvation Army bell, and literally 17 million baby boomers just moved here. They're all coming here. So, you know what? This is an awesome place to live. It's a fantastic place to celebrate the holidays. And it's just gorgeous.
And most
it's beautiful.
People, when they come here, especially when they're cutting and they're stuck in that snow, they want to move here. So the thing is that you want to call Roland Bennett. You've been doing this for so long. You're also licensed in 16 states.
16 states, absolutely.
So, you know,
and, you know, at the holidays, we got to do a little PSA,
do
right?
Do something fun.
Well, I'm not really a funny guy, but leave the two-drink minimum for the comedy clubs, okay? Let's try to make our streets safe out there. You know, life's crazy enough already. If you're having it, just, you know, get an Uber. You know what I mean? Let's make sure we have more holidays.
Please pull over right now. Do not just text him and drive, right?
Well, you got to pull over to the side of the road and
make sure you know,
because I've taken the pledge. I want you to take the pledge, too. I do have to say hello to my little girls. They have been waking up. They wake up every morning. They look for Susie and Sprinkles, and those are our elves that come visit every morning. And it's just so much fun because I could not believe what they did today. It was just nuts. I'm not sure if I can say it on air.
No, we're not going to say it on air. But you know what? Wish them a very happy holiday and have a really wonderful new year.
I will. And to all your listeners, it's so great being on the Carol Blonder Show. I mean, you put the H in holidays. You know what I mean? It's awesome to be here. I want to wish you a happy new year.
You too.
And I'll look forward to seeing you next year.
Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks, Carol.
Guys, give him a call. The number is 602-513-3686. It's RolandBennettLoans.com. That's Bennett with two T's. RolandBennettLoans.com.